Good morning, everyone, and happy Sunday. How is everyone today? I'm doing wonderful. So, as you recall, we've been talking about communities, right? And today, in your worksheets that you received, if you received them, and if not, you can make your own. There was two papers. One is another version of the story, but this one is growing flowers. So if you have this sheet, what you're going to do is you're going to color these with crayons, and then there's instructions in the back. You punch them out, then you fold the petals in, and you place them in a bowl or a small tub of water on the table. And what will happen is you'll lay them in the bowl of water with the non-colored side down, and you're going to watch the petals open up. So if you don't have one of these, make your own flowers. Well, not only can you do the flowers and watch them open up, but something else you can do is to make a bird feeder out of cereal that has, you know, that are O-shaped, that have the holes in the middle of them, and a Chanel stem if you have one of those. So what you'll do is you'll put the cereal on the Chanel stem and then have an adult help you close that, and then you hang it on the tree. But don't forget, once all the cereal's gone, that you need to go get that stem and throw it in the trash. So we've been talking or learning stories about how communities change and grow. We've learned how leaders have helped us grow and change. Today we're going to hear about God's kingdom and how it grows and changes. How do you think people change and grow? Well, I'm a lot taller than you are, aren't I? If you're a child that's watching. But we all start as a baby and then we all grow up. So that's how we grow. But we might also grow in knowledge. You know, school's really important because it teaches us how to do things and how to learn and how to be friends with people. So we spend our whole lives growing and changing, just in different ways. So I wonder, how do you feel today? I already told you earlier that I'm wonderful. I hope you are too. What's one thing that happened in your community this week that you really liked? For me, I don't know, it was a really busy week, but I and a lot of other people at Overbrook United Methodist Church prepared for our vacation Bible school that's going to be virtual this year. So if you're watching this and you haven't joined our virtual VBS group on Facebook, please do that, because that's the only way you're going to be able to see our virtual VBS. And it's Knights of North Castle, and everybody gets to be a knight, and we get to learn and grow in God and put on the armor of God. So find that virtual VBS group. If you look for Overbrook United Methodist Church's Facebook page, there's a link there for you. So, how about we listen to our Bible story now? And it comes from the book of Luke, chapter 13, verses 18 through 21. And it's titled, The Mustard Seed and Yeast. Jesus asked, "What is God's kingdom like? What can I compare God's kingdom to?" God's kingdom is like a tiny mustard seed that someone planted in a garden. The mustard seed grew and grew and became a tree. It got so big that the birds nested in its branches. Jesus continued, "God's kingdom is like yeast that a woman hid in flour. The yeast made all the flour grow into raised dough. What do you think God's kingdom is like? I think it's a pretty neat place. What is a small thing that you might be able to do that would make a big difference? There's so many things out there. You know, you could hold a door open for someone. You could pick something up that someone has dropped. Maybe you could put all of your toys away before mom and dad ask you to. There's a lot of little things that you can do that will make a huge difference. How about we say our Bible verse? Do you all remember it? We've had it now for a few weeks. Here we go. Why don't you say it with me? The Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Joshua 1:9 C. Let's say it again. The Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Joshua 1:9. So as we close our Sunday school time together, I want you to remember that God truly does go with you wherever you go. He's right there with you, right by your side. Should we pray? Dear God, thank you for always being with us. Amen. Bye, everyone. I'll see you right here again next week, or maybe I'll see you at church in a few minutes. Bye.